Hello, good morning, everyone. I am on my way to work and sitting in a red light at the moment. Thought I'd come on and say hello. It's been probably 2 weeks since I made a video, I think, since my last confession. It's been busy 2 weeks, I guess. Just a lot going on with work and the kids and, you know, the usual. But I've missed making videos, and I had Mia in my arms this morning and I was going to bring her with me, but it is supposed to rain literally all day. And I figured it wouldn't be very nice lighting anyway, and I mean, I know she's silicone, she can get wet, but I don't know. Something about dragging a baby around in the rain, it's just very unappealing, whether it's real or not. So I decided against that. You're just going to have to stare at my mug this time. But today's Friday. Whoop, whoop. Ready for the weekend for sure. And hopefully have some fun things going on. There is a dog walk that benefits a local animal shelter that is going on this weekend. And we're planning to take Kicker, Kix. All right, Kix is our Pomeranian rescue pup that we rescued from this shelter that's having the fundraiser. So I'm excited to go. They've had this fundraiser for many years and I've never gone to it. So I'm hoping that the weather's nice because it's a rain or shine event. So, but you know, I'm not real keen on running around in the rain. So I may not go if it's raining. Or if I do, it'll be very brief. But, and you know, wet dog, ugh, it's not good. So anyway, Callie is hitting the job market. I helped her apply for 2 jobs last night. She has an interview coming up. She had an interview already, or 2 interviews actually already. And you know, she didn't get those positions, but interviewing is part of the process where you can learn and grow. So that's a good thing that she at least got the opportunity to interview. And it's really raining, so I hope I've raised my voice a little, but I hope it's not too loud. But I know the rain is loud, so. But yeah, we had beautiful weather the last few days, and now today it's just raining. It's supposed to rain all day, so. And then little Goldie, she is, what has she been doing? Well, she's trying to find a job too. She's 14 and she has a worker's permit, and she's just trying to find, you know, a few hours to get started, you know, getting used to the idea of working. And she's applied at 3 different places. We called one just yesterday to follow up and see if, you know, if they received her application okay, and to inquire about the status of her application. So, she didn't have good luck with that call because they're not hiring at the moment, but I told her, I said, it's good practice to get into that habit of, you know, following up after you put in an application. I said, some companies frown upon that, but I said, most of them really love it when you call and inquire about your status, because that shows initiative and, you know, it shows interest and all of those lovely things that employers like to know about and hear. But yeah, that's what's going on with us. My husband is doing pretty well. We're still working on our getting ready to replace our roof. That's supposed to happen next month. And it's a lot more expensive than what I thought, but we're getting a good quality product, and it's being done by a good contractor that has rave reviews, which is always good. And anybody that we've talked to in person that has used this company has nothing but nice things to say. And the other companies that we looked into did not have that kind of rating. So we went with the best one. And the best one you pay for, just like most things. So the hard part with us now is picking out a color. Luckily for us, there isn't a huge palette to choose from in this product that we're going with. So we've narrowed it down to, I think, 5 choices, I want to say. And we're waiting for samples, bigger samples. Right now, we just have like little color chips like you get at a paint store or something like that. But they're, you know, pasted on a piece of paper all together. And we want to see like a bigger sample. And the samples are actually the... we're putting on a tin roof, by the way. I don't know if I said that. But the samples are actually pieces of that tin so that we can... tin, metal, whatever it's made out of. So that we can see the true color, as opposed to sometimes color chips and swatches and things like that aren't true to the color. So, yeah, it's exciting. We're hoping to get the swatches by this weekend. There was a little bit of a mix-up with getting them to us earlier, but they're coming. Does anybody have anything fun planned for the weekend? The dog jog is really the only thing that we've got going on that's, you know, fun. We, of course, have to go get groceries. We go get groceries every week because we buy fresh produce. So, you know, we only buy enough to last the week because, you know how produce is. It only lasts for so long. So, I'm eating the last pear this morning and... husband, I think we're out of apples. I think we're out of apples like Wednesday. Bananas go really fast in our house. Goldie hates bananas. But my other daughter, Callie, she loves them and she will sit down and eat, you know, 2 or 3 of them in one sitting. I tried to tell her not to do that. But, you know, I'd rather her indulge on something like that than candy. So... I guess pick your battles, right? With that. I have a silicone baby in the works. The baby is finished. The painting is finished. The matting is everything is done. And I was expecting the little one to come home to me without hair because the person that I was going to have root the baby had an unfortunate incident happen and basically was not taking any more orders at the time. So I told the painter, and they're 2 different people, I told the painter that, you know, hey, just send the baby home and I will take my time and see maybe if this woman gets better, I will, you know, send him to her later, or I'll just have to go shopping and find another person. Well, I contacted her just because I said I wasn't going to, and I just did. And I just said, hey, I'm really sorry to hear what happened to you. You were going to root my baby, and, you know, I just wanted to find out how you're doing and maybe like a timeline if you have it. And I said, if you don't, that's totally fine. I said, it's okay. But I said, if you have a timeline, like, then I could get sort of an idea of, you know, what I want to do and, you know, that kind of thing. And she got back to me and she said that she, you know, she made a miraculous recovery and she's doing much better now. And she can take the doll within a week or two. And I was like, oh, okay, that's great. You know, I'm so happy that you're better and this is wonderful news about the rooting situation. So I contacted the painter and I said, hey, change of plans. I said, can you just send the doll to the rooter? That's how we originally planned for it to happen. And there's positives, pros and cons to that because, A, I don't get to see the painting before the rooting happens. That's sort of a con. But the pro is that I don't have to pay for... I get out of paying one shipping method. Because if the painter sends the doll to me, I pay for the shipping. And then I pay for the shipping again to send it out to somebody, the rooter. And then I pay for the shipping yet again for the rooter to send it back to me. And in this case... I avoid one layer of shipping. And shipping is expensive, especially when you're shipping an 8-9 pound doll around. So I think I paid almost $74 to ship it one way, and that was like with insurance and all that. And that was because the painter insisted that, you know, there be insurance on the package. When I shipped the baby to her originally, I did not insure it. I just did it. I know that was a risk, but it was way cheaper. But yeah, you know, sometimes you just have to do what you gotta do, so. So yeah, I'm eagerly awaiting. I don't know how long it's going to be yet, but it is nice to not have to think about shipping the doll out again. You know, because the more times it travels, the more, or the higher the risk of something happening, either damage or the package being lost or something like that. And then there's always the issue of, if I get the doll and it would be bald, would I feel comfortable sending it out again? Because I'd get attached to the baby and all of that too. So that's hard to do too. So yeah, I was just glad that it worked out that way. You know, all I have is pictures to go on the painting and everything. So, and honestly, if I don't like the painting or something, I don't think I'm not gonna not like it. The pictures are pretty nice. But dolls don't sell very well that are bald anyway. So you almost have to get hair either painted or rooted on a doll, because the bald ones don't sell. I mean, they do eventually, but they don't sell very well, so you're kind of forced. But I'm not even thinking, I mean, I am thinking about that, you know, things like that happen where you think you're going to love a baby and, you know, it gets home to you, and then next thing you know, you decide there's something about it you don't like, or maybe, you know, it doesn't feel right to hold it, or there's just something that you don't care for. So then you turn around and put it on the second market. So I do think about that whenever I am in the process of purchasing a doll or getting one created for me or whatever. Because there is that chance. Regardless, there's always that chance. Sometimes you fall in love with a sculpt, but then when you get it and see it in person, you don't feel the same way about it after a while, or even right away. So, me, when I open a doll, regardless of whether I'm in love with the sculpt or not, the bond for me takes time. I don't instantly fall in love with a doll. Usually. I usually like to really look them over for like days. I'll look them over for days. Not straight, obviously. I do sleep. But, you know, I look them over and I study them and I just kind of, not looking for flaws necessarily, but just admiring the artwork. And I don't know, it's almost like when you first meet somebody, you don't instantly, well, sometimes you instantly connect with people, but a lot of times you don't, you're not instantly friends when you first meet somebody, right? Or you don't instantly love somebody when you first meet them. It takes time. Well, that's how I am with the dolls too. And so it just takes time for me. So it's easier for me to give up a doll that I just purchased than it is for me to give up one that I've had in my collection for a while. Because the ones that have been around are the ones that I'm pretty bonded with, and it's hard. And I am parting with some dolls that I've been bonded with, and it is hard. I back and forth and back and forth about it, and all the time. So it's a battle for sure. But I know a lot of people have a strong bond at first, and then over time they lose that connection, or another one comes out that pulls at their heartstrings, you know, more so they give up that one to get another one. And you know, that's just part of how they collect too. I'm just the oddball opposite weirdo. Does it backwards. No, I'm sure there's more of people like me out there too. But anyway. So all right, guys, I'm going to let you go. I just wanted to come on and say hello. I'm still around, and you know, I haven't been really feeling like making videos lately either. So that's kind of part of it. I think a lot of it has to do with just being tired and being busy, you know, having a lot to do and that kind of thing. So, but yeah, I'll come back on soon, hopefully. And I will do my best to bring a baby with me. I brought a baby with me, brought Killian with me the other day. And I was going to make, with the intention of making a video with him. Because I don't just bring dolls with me just to bring dolls with me. I usually plan to make a video in my car. And my husband and I were talking on the phone the whole ride to work. And we almost never do that. Because when he gets off work in early in the morning, he wants to go home and do what he needs to do. And then he goes to sleep right away. How he does that, I have no idea. I have to unwind no matter what time it is when I get home from somewhere. I can't just hop in bed and go to sleep, but he does. It's like amazing to me that he can do that. But yeah, so we talked the whole way to here, to my work. So I did not get a chance to make a video. And then on the way home, it's harder for me to make a video. I can't really explain why. I think it's because the sun is partially a lighting thing, but it's also partially lack of interest, maybe. I'm more alert in mornings than I am in the afternoons. So, I don't know. It's a mixture of things for sure. But anyway, I will talk to you all soon. And I hope you all have a wonderful weekend. Stay safe, and see you again.